Hey guys, welcome to Hungry Vacations. Today we are going to talk about the succulent plants. These plants usually survive in extreme weather conditions and less water requirements. Succulents are often grown as ornamental plants who store water in various structures like leaves or stem, having unusual fleshy and striking appearance, also known as drought-resistant plants. Succulents are low maintenance, can be decorated in all forms of color, shape and sizes. They are perfect year-round and can make great silent companions. Overall, they are perfect for home decor. Our first plant is Ruby Ball Cactus. This red ball is not a flower, it is albino cactus without chlorophyll, who cannot survive on its own. It only lives if grafted on green cactus that can carry out photosynthesis. So the red cactus depends on the green cactus for survival. Albino can burn in full sun, so keep in indirect sunlight. Water it once in 15 days and avoid overwatering. Hevorthia margaritifera P. It has slightly wider leaves. Warts are more dotted, producing a pearl-type effect, so it is also known as pearl plant. It usually grows slow and the height varies from 2 to 8 inches. It loves to stay in indirect sunlight and mostly indoors. Water once in 15 days as it is tolerant of underwatering and it can rot if overwatered. It is an evergreen pendant succulent with long hanging stem and fleshy leaves, normally known as Sedum burrito baby donkey, and its common name is stone crop. This plant needs too much sun and too little water to survive. Unfortunately, my sedum didn't survive long as I mistakenly kept it indoors in spite of keeping it in sunlight, and the leaves started rotting and fallen off.
Guys, this is my small collection of plants and I wish to have some more of them. If you have any suggestions, do tell me in the comment box below. I would love to buy them. And if you like this video, do subscribe my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. Stay connected. Thanks for watching.